speaking here with our head coach of our national under 17 women's team and director of women's development in Trinidad and Tobago, Mr. Evan Pellerud, obviously world renowned, having worked with Norway and also the Canadian teams. Coach, you've been here with us for quite some time now, not as long as we would have hoped, but so far you've been able to put a program into place and you've implemented this program as we look forward to next year's championship. Tell us a bit about your time here in Trinidad. How would you describe what you've experienced here since your arrival?
Well, my first and primary objective has to get to know all players or all the infrastructure of football in Trinidad and Tobago, and of course work closely and every day with the under 17 team, which has a fast upcoming World Cup in September next year, as you said. My next priority has to help the under 20 team in this qualification for CONCACAF in January. I'm pleased with how both those two teams have developed nicely over the last 8 months. I think we're on the right track for both teams. We see nice development of discipline and understanding of the tactical game. Fitness-wise, we are seeing great improvement for both teams. We are implementing the foreign-based players into the under 17 squad in a nice way, and the same with the under 20 team. So I think we're on the right track with those two teams. We have also started an under 15 program, and we will soon start up with the under 13 program as well. So on the youth side of things, I think we are looking quite good in the federation right now on the women's side. Also going into 2010 now, we need to get the senior women's team on track, because there is a World Cup qualifying coming up next, probably November. So we have only a year minus now to work on that team as well. That's a hard question. I think you see globally now that you will see a lot of mixed styles of play and philosophies. You see, for example, the 1960s and 70s and 80s British football has changed to a continental style, because they have recruited players from all over across the world, and it works. And while on the other side, you see a lot of other countries that used to play with deep sweeper and marking and very possession-oriented football, has now become more direct, more counter-attack oriented, and play with a flat back four and a high goalkeeper in the goal. You know, you see styles are coming closer and closer to each other, and certainly I have implemented some new things into this style here in Trinidad and Tobago, where we are trying to play more disciplined, more tactical, quicker, and more physical. And I'm very pleased with how all the teams have adjusted to that. A little bit of an adjustment to style, and I'm convinced that we will see more improvement moving forward.
Okay, it's under a year now before what will be the first game for the national team in next year's tournament. Do you have a fair idea of what your squad is going to be like, and when can we expect that final list to be out? And until then, is it that the door is open to any player who's eligible?
The door is open, and once in a while we have some trials from local based players. We see though the fact that it will always be open for new talents to come in wherever they live, we see certainly that the current and existing squad we are working with have become so fit, so it's really hard to mix in and compete with them. We have seen players coming in and break down first practice. So it's going to be harder and harder to break in, but I will always have an open eye for an amazing talent coming in for a child.
What has your scouting program been like? Have you had people working on behalf of yourself and the Federation out there in North America, or even some parts of Europe, looking to see what players may be available for Trinidad and Tobago?
Well, both myself have a nice network in North America, and my colleagues in the coaching staff knows a lot of our coaches have network in North America, and of course in Trinidad and Tobago. And of course, a lot of players and parents are contacting us for a child. I don't think I'm missing many out. I think we have a nice control on the potential players, both here and abroad at the moment.
All right. If you were to perhaps draw Canada in your group next year, how much would you relish that opportunity to face the Canadians on home soil here in Trinidad?
That would be great. But Canada has a qualifier first, and they will have a challenge doing that, I think, coming March. because I know that the Canadian funding for that team is not great at the moment. But I would not mind to be in the group of Canada. But you know, this is a business. This is my business, and whichever team we have, we will go in there with the goal to beat them.
All right. Aside from, you know, being brought here, as we were told when you arrived here at the launching of your tenure, that you were here to prepare this national under 17 team for next year's tournament, do you see yourself laying that foundation, or if not laying the foundation, making that foundation a lot more solid for women's football in general for the future in Trinidad here?
Well, you certainly see already a much larger interest for women's football already, and I think that will grow and grow and grow until the next September when the World Cup takes place. And when World Cup, when the women's soccer has taken roots, it's going to be impossible to ignore it. I think they set the standard for how to train and how to prepare a team. And I'm sure that all young girls in Trinidad Tobago now, from now on, will have football as a sport number one. That's the same that happened in Canada, the same that happens in Europe, and the same that happens everywhere. Football becomes sport number one.
Okay, great.